Are you wondering how to make your project a reality with user guiding? In this video, we'll show you how to accomplish that. Here we have a simple four-step onboarding flow focused on trial conversion, and we chose the Notion app to illustrate our use case. To start, we've converted each one of these steps into guides, and I'm super excited to show you how they look and behave. Here is our checklist that allows a user to trigger the guides by using the launcher. We set the guides to be unlocked in order to ensure our users follow the sequence from the onboarding flow. So let's play our first guide where we welcome our trial users on board. We also added a video to it introducing the app. As you can see, when a user completes a guide, they will receive a green check mark. Now let's explain the basics of getting started with a pre-made template. The cool thing about guides is that you can link your steps to HTML elements from your page, making them super intuitive. Remember to not overwhelm your users by not adding too many steps. Then let's teach them how to create their first page. When using guides, you can instruct your users where they need to click so that they don't get lost. To start, they will enter a new title, then choose an empty page to start from scratch. And finally, enter some content into the page. We are just adding some dummy text to show you how the guide behaves. Great, here we have our new page. As we planned in our onboarding flow, we finish it by offering a 25% discount for those who reach the final guide. To celebrate, we added an animation to our checklist confirming that they have completed the whole flow. Great job! We also created a resource center for this project, which works as a 24-hour help center for your users. And we added some exciting things to it. First, we added some product updates for the current month, showing our users what's new. Remember that in-app messaging is a very effective way of communicating with your audience. The Resource Center is also a great shortcut for useful links. Here, we link the URL where our trial users can schedule a demo with the sales team. If your knowledge base is indexed by Google and compatible with external requests, your users can search for your articles and preview them within the Resource Center. Or, if they prefer, they can open it in a new tab. You can also add checklists to your Resource Center. Here, we added the same checklist, allowing our users to redo any of the completed guides. Next, you probably have noticed some beacon icons across the page. We call them hotspots, which are usually used to catch the user's attention in a non-intrusive way. A very common use case is when something on your interface has changed. In this example, a new menu option was added to the app. So we used the hotspot to encourage our users to take some action. You can even add a guide to a hotspot so that they can initiate a tour. Hotspots can also be used to explain terminologies. To make it even clearer, you can link it to an article from your knowledge base. That will ensure your users have all the needed resources. Once the user has got the idea, they can simply dismiss the hotspot. To finish our project, we'll also show a promoter survey, as known as NPS, for users who have interacted with our content. By doing this, we'll know if we are on the right track. To gather even more feedback, we enabled an option for the users to justify their scores. Looks like they are super happy with us. And we're done! I hope this video inspired you enough to start your new project with user guiding or improve your existing one. User guiding is a simple but powerful tool that will take your onboarding and product adoption projects to the next level.